automatic stabilization of brightness. When using fluoroscopy, you may notice when panning the fluoroscope to different regions of the body where patient thickness varies, the image will degrade briefly before being displayed at the appropriate level of brightness. This is due to modern advancements which allow for automatic adjustment to compensate for part thickness or variations in tissue density. The first approach to compensating for patient variations in your fluoroscopic image is automatic gain control. This is when amplification of the electronic signal is increased or decreased, as needed, after the image is acquired. Please note that this adjustment is made within the viewing system and does not require an increase or decrease in technical factors to the X-ray beam, so patient dose is not affected. The only change that occurs is the amount of electric current flowing into the display monitor. Results of AGC are somewhat limited, though. Think of this as post-processing. If the X-ray beam is not sufficient so that the image feeding into the display is mottled or noisy, no amount of post-processing or gain control will be sufficient to fix the image. It is entirely dependent upon the signal put out from the fluoroscope. Automatic brightness stabilization is more common to see in modern fluoroscopes. With this system, radiographic technical factors are adjusted based on various levels of detection to compensate for fluctuations in signal. These fluctuations can be measured in the incident X-ray beam, the electronic signal produced, or the actual brightness level of light at different stages in the image intensification process. The two most common methods for sensing and measuring the adequacy of signal flowing through the fluorosystems are to sample the signal at either the photocathode region of the II or within the camera tube. With the photocathode method, the photocathode is normally connected to the ground, while the anode is connected to the source of the 25 to 35 kV required to operate it. The ground can be fed into an amplifier so that the output current is proportional to the incident X-ray input. With the TV camera method, the AGC circuits for controlling the camera tube voltage, or the gain in the video amplifiers, are employed in order to provide a constant output signal over variations in image brightness. We generally talk about the different types of ABS circuits in terms of which variables are controlled by the brightness sensors. With a variable MA preset KVP model, the operator sets the KVP value to a fixed point, usually based on the type of exam or part thickness, and the tube current is increased or decreased based on the data detected at the sensor to create the appropriate brightness level. Then there's a variable MA with KVP following system. The MA is variable just like the previous method, but there's an added feature that allows a system to detect a high or low boundary for the MA settings. Once those boundaries are reached as the brightness is adjusted, the variability of the MA stops, and then the KVP is adjusted by a motor so that MA values don't get too high, causing too much patient dose, or too low, causing image noise. Next, we have a variable KVP with selected MA model. Put very simply, the MA doesn't change. Tell the motor driving KVP when to adjust. This typically results in faster visible compensation seen on the display monitor, and is especially useful for contrast examinations. Finally, we have the variable KVP with variable MA system. Here, the output brightness sensor controls both technical factors, preventing constant changes in the image contrast and image noise levels. Fluoroscopes with this kind of system usually have various modes selectable at the control panel, and it can make it difficult to select the most appropriate mode to utilize for the specific type of imaging needed. A properly designed ABS system must be able to accomplish some objectives, and we can test this ability to meet these with quality control testing, which we will cover later in the course. These objectives are: it must maintain the image brightness constant for variations in patient thickness and beam attenuation. It must ignore information at the image margins. It must operate to preserve image contrast while minimizing image noise or model. It must keep the orientation within the ratings of the X-ray tube. It must keep the operation within the ratings of the X-ray tube, meaning KVP and MA values. It must affect a reasonable compromise between patient exposure and image quality. It must keep patient exposure within radiation control regulations previously discussed of 100 milligray per minute, except when the operator selects an override mode of operation. It also must respond fast enough to track during an exam, but slowly enough to avoid hunting between bright and dark portions of the image. It must be able to compensate for system variables such as magnification, the intensifier, and use of disc recorders. It must be capable of being disabled or held at a particular equilibrium value prior to injection of contrast media. It must be capable of being shut off to permit the technologist to manually control technical factors. And finally, it must display the operating factors and modes of operation.